It's Weezy, the Sexy Grandma 2K, and I'm coming at you today with a new addition to our strong and beautiful sleigh. If you guys haven't been catching these sleighs, I mean, I don't know what to tell you. I just don't know, sis. We are like not only laying down the lace, but we're laying down the knowledge in honor of Black History Month. So what we're doing is I've teamed up with 12 of your favorite wig bays, and we're not only doing wig or makeup reviews, but we're also telling you about an African-American trailblazer who's made a difference in our culture. So with that said, the person that I'm going to be collaborating with today, okay, I got to say I absolutely love her. But I really do. She is my YouTube bestie. And let me tell you, she is so supportive, so kind, so doggone knowledgeable. And so guys, with that said, the person I am talking about is still looking good, 58. Now don't get it twisted. She's not 58 years old. She's actually, I believe, 62 years old. And baby, she is sexy. If you haven't checked her out, please make sure you go over, check her channel out. You're gonna absolutely love it. She's gonna bring you wig reviews. She's gonna bring you try-on hauls. She's gonna bring you some cooking and recipes. She actually wrote a cookbook and other books. And she's also going to be bringing you relationship goals. Woo-hoo-hoo! So you're going to get a little bit of everything over there, okay? I'm going to leave all her information in the description box below. So you all, the person that I'm going to be bringing to you today, I am so excited about this one. This person is just so special that I don't even know, y'all. Y'all gonna see what I'm talking about here in just a minute, okay? But before we even go there, Faith and I decided to bring you the exact same wig in the exact same color so that you can see what it looks like on dark complexions as well as light complexions, okay? Now, the wig that I'm talking about, don't play with me. Y'all already know it's Outre. Y'all know they dropping bangers after banger after banger. So this is actually from the Melted Hairline, and it is Arlissa. This is what Miss Arlissa is looking like. We both got her in the color DR2 Ginger Brown. So we're going to get her unboxed. I'm going to tell you about all of her deets. But more importantly, I'm going to tell you about this special African-American trailblazer. Y'all ready? Take you a seat, get you something to drink, and just chillax, as my grandbaby say. If you're coming from Faith's channel, hey girl, hey boy, I'm glad you're here. I hope that you see something you like this sleighage, and that you hit that subscribe button. Anyway, y'all, come on, we got things to do. Let's go, Arlissa. Y'all, so the person I'm gonna be telling you about today is Judge Darren Philip Gales. Judge Gales is a United States District Judge for the Southern District of Florida. On February the 6th of 2014, President Barack Obama, remember him, number 44, nominated Judge Gales to fill a vacancy on the district court. Following President Obama's historic nomination of Judge Gales, the United States Senate unanimously confirmed Judge Gales' nomination by a, hold on to y'all seat, 98-0 vote. Now, once President Obama signed Judge Gales' commission, he then became the nation's very first openly gay African-American man to serve on the federal bench. So what is a federal judge? I'm glad you asked, sis. So federal judges are appointed for a lifetime tenure. They are nominated by the President of the United States and confirmed by the U.S. Senate in accordance with Article 3 of the United States Constitution. Federal judges serve in the Supreme Court of the United States, and they also serve either the U.S. Courts of Appeal or U.S. District Courts.
Federal judges exercise what Article 3 calls the judicial power of the United States. A federal judge's salary cannot be reduced by Congress during their continuance in office. So Congress cannot mess with their coins. Okay, guys, so I like to just give a little background because otherwise I'd be like, okay, what? So what that mean? So anyway, which judges are federal judges? The U.S. Supreme Court has 9 justices. The U.S. Courts of Appeals has 179 judgeships. The United States District Court has 678 judgeships. And the U.S. Court of International Trade has 9 judgeships. So how do you become a federal judge? The president nominates the individual for a judicial seat. Then the nominee fills out a questionnaire, and it is reviewed by the Senate Judiciary Committee. The Senate Judiciary Committee holds a hearing with the nominee. They question them about things like their judicial philosophy, past rulings, and opinions. So after they interview the nominee, the committee then sends a blue slip to the senator, and he or she will either approve and send that blue slip back, or they'll disapprove. Now, once that blue slip is received back from the senator with their approval, the Senate Judiciary Committee then votes themselves on whether or not to approve the nominee. If they approve, then the nominee is voted on by the full Senate. But if the full Senate denies the nominee, then that nominee is returned to the president, and the president has to pick someone else. Now, if the full Senate approves the nominee, then they are commissioned by the president to serve a lifelong federal judge position. And whoop, whoop, that's how you get a federal judgeship. So anyway, guys, I am so sorry about this audio. I cannot find my microphone. So anyway, back to Judge Darren P. Gales. Judge Gales was born on December the 16th in 1966 in Peoria, Illinois, to James E. Gales and Janie Banks Gales, who married in 1966. Judge Gales' mother was a member of the Carpenters and Joiners Union prior to serving as a reservist in the United States Naval Construction Battalion, known as the Seabees. After her service, she joined the staff of Howard University Hospital as a special police officer. And in 2018, she passed away unexpectedly of heart failure at her home. Her husband preceded her in death when Judge Gales was a young child. Judge Gales and his mother spent an abundance of time together, and she absolutely loved and adored him. Now, he does have one sister. Her name is Monica. They were very close growing up, and she did go on to become a successful entrepreneur. Judge Gales was the first in his family to graduate from college and the only one to attend law school. In 1990, he graduated from Howard University with a bachelor's degree in political science. And at Howard, his fellow students elected him to serve as their representative on the prestigious Howard University Board of Trustees. While at Howard, he also was selected as one of the inaugural Patricia Roberts Harris Fellows. What is the Patricia Roberts Harris Fellowship? Well, I'm glad you asked that too, sis. The fellowship is awarded to undergraduate students who excel academically within their communities, duly recognizing the importance of service. The fellowship was designed to support students who are committed to a future as global leaders. Now, in 1993, Judge Gales obtained his law degree from George Washington University Law School, after which he began his legal career in 1993 as well as an assistant state attorney in Miami-Dade County, Florida. And he was among the last class of assistant state attorneys hired by former U.S. Attorney General Janet Reno. In 97, he was hired by the U.S. Department of Justice as an assistant district counsel for the Immigration and Naturalization Service. And 2 years later, in 99, Judge Gales was hired as an assistant U.S. attorney for the Southern District of Florida and served the office's appellate major crimes and narcotics section until his appointment to the county court in 2004. Also that same year, former Governor Jeb Bush appointed Judge Gales to the County Court of Florida's 11th Judicial Circuit, where he had previously served for more than 10 years as a judge. Now, in 2011, former Florida Governor Charlie Crist promoted him to the Circuit Court, where he was retained without opposition for two whole terms, y'all. So in 2006 and 2012, respectively, until his federal appointment, which came in 2014. I mean, do y'all hear all of his accomplishments? He must have really put in some work and had a lot of favor, because brother man just kept leveling up. I mean, anytime you got two former governors that hired you and an attorney general that hired you, and the kicker is President Obama even knows your name and nominates you as a federal judge at the age of only 48 years. I'm like, oh my God, what am I doing with my life? Now, Judge Gales is a leader and active participant in South Florida's legal and civic communities. He's involved in numerous legal and community services. Y'all, I couldn't even name all that stuff. Just to name like a couple of things, he served on the board of directors of the South Florida's chapter of the Federal Bar Association. He was previously appointed to co-chair the 11th Judicial Circuit's Long Range Planning Committee and Committee on Professionalism. He oversaw the circuit's first professional and civility summit and new attorney breakfast. Not to mention, he has been a lecturer, panelist, and chaired a number of voluntary American Bar Association conferences, especially in regards to professionalism and civility in the legal profession. He's also a member of the National Bar Association. Judge Gales was a longtime trustee of the historic Greater Bethel AME Church in Miami. He's also volunteered on several local and national community service organizations, such as the 100 Black Men of South Florida, Congresswoman Frederica Wilson's 500 Role Models of Excellence Project, and he's volunteered with the Big Brothers Big Sisters Association. And y'all, that's just to name a few things. I'm telling you, brother's sheet is so long, I couldn't even, that was a lot. Now, you all, he's been the featured speaker at several churches, schools, and civic organizations, and gave the keynote address to over 3,000 new citizens in 2004. Judge Gales has been the recipient of copious awards and acknowledgments. He's been recognized as one of South Florida's most powerful Black business leaders. And y'all, fun fact, Judge Gales is a member of the Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated. Here's another fun fact. Did you know there was an appropriate way to address a federal judge? So, if you're speaking of him, you would say Judge Gales. If you're writing about him, you would say the Honorable Darren Philip Gales. And if you were sitting in his courtroom before him, you would say Your Honor. So my goal would be to never have to call him Your Honor. So you all, Judge Gales is a very distinguished and respected jurist and definitely an African-American trailblazer. Oh, and wait, you guys. I forgot to tell you the most important role Judge Gales has ever played in his life, being my first cousin. Not only is Judge Gales my first cousin, but he's literally my firstborn cousin. And I am so very proud of him. Our whole family absolutely loves, adores, respects, and cherishes him. And I hope you all have enjoyed hearing about his historic journey in becoming the first African American openly gay federal judge, Judge Darren Philip Gales.
Okay, y'all, let's talk about this. Ooh, child. Okay, as you all know, it's the melted hairline. They pretty much stay the same. I'm not going to keep y'all long. HD lace, the 2x5 lace frontal, the ear contouring, front effect hairline, pre-plucked, and the HD transparent lace, heat safe up to 400 degrees. All right. And baby hairs. So, girl, get your life. I'm just going to say one thing. I ain't got nothing else to say. This thing is, look at that. This thing is beautiful. Oh my God, and I love this color. I haven't even tried this color before, I don't think, but it is absolutely beautiful. Okay, so big hair friendly, yes. I would say to me on the melted hairline, you know, they give you like so much lace on the front that that's what they mean by the contour ear thing. Like you can literally cut as much of that lace off as you need to contour it to your hairline, which is what you saw me do. Like I had to cut this back because it was coming too far forward the whole hairline. Now, if you're one of those people that have like, and don't be bragging, sis, a lot of edges, this will really help you out because you can kind of hide your edges, you know, when you cut it to your hairline, contour it to your hairline. So yeah, I think it's definitely big hair friendly. And I think you can definitely fix it to make it work for you. Oh, let me tell you guys something. Okay, so it does have baby hairs and I love the baby hairs on the perfect hairline and the melted hairline because they're nice and wispy. They're long, so you can cut them to whatever length you want. But when I lay my lace, I generally like make me a little sideburn here. So if you're having trouble with your lace lifting on the sides, make you a little sideburn and then lay that little sideburn just like you would like your baby hairs and your lace. And so when I do that, when I make me a little sideburn, I find that my sides will stay laying down because let me tell you, my struggle has been real over the years with that. But I think I finally figured it out. So yeah, you're welcome. I'm not going to say anything about shedding because I don't care for real. Like as long as it ain't like going to be bald headed by the end of my review, because like I said, I contour my hairline. So I think some hair is going to come out, but actually you guys, I haven't gotten any shedding. I'm like looking around to see, but I haven't gotten any shedding, like literally. I will say tangling. So it really hasn't tangled for me, but I can tell that it eventually will tangle. See, I can run my fingers through it. I'm not catching anything. Y'all, this wig pretty. I'm sorry. This wig is cute. Now I, because I made my baby hairs and the way that I lay my lace, like I can go through this with like one of these combs, a rat tooth comb, and I can like comb through it to kind of get that product out. Cause like I laid this bad boy. So if you comb through it without lifting your laces, then you can get it styled to how it is on the stock card if you want. See that? See how it's coming around? But, I mean, I do like mine to go back. And this little comb I have, I mean, it's been through some things, sis. But it's perfect for this, for lifting your lace, you know, when you want to lift the hair off of your lace when you lay it. Because it's got the little comb. It's got the brush and then it's got a little comb built on there. Mm-hmm, my favorite store, Amazon. I will say like the curls, This right here might be a little annoying eventually, but I'm okay with it right now. I'm just rambling because I have nothing bad to say, for real. Like, I'm getting me another one. Oh, this thing is a winner! On a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being the best, this gets an 11. Yes. All right, you guys, I'm not going to keep you anymore. We're going to head over to Faith's channel, see what she got for us. That's still looking good, 58, and see how it looks on her. Okay, so there you go, sis. We're bringing you options. You can see for dark skin and for light skin. Please hit that like button for me. Subscribe if you're not subscribed already. And we just have a few more strong and beautiful slays to bring you. We may run over just a little bit into March because life happens. All right, guys. Love you so much. Be blessed. And remember what I always say, sis, to show somebody a little piece of heaven today. This is Wheezy, the sexy grandma 2K, and I'll see you guys on the next slay. Bye. Head on over to Still Looking Good 58. Bye, guys.
Tell you something I could do. I could be running or I'm chasing you, but I won't, 'cause I got better things to do. Rather spend my precious time chasing somebody who loves me too. If I got a dollar for every time you slam the door, I would be the